Dude, that class encompasses all different grades and ages. There are about 30 students at different levels, and they all study in the same class. That is fucking weird. I'm told that long ago there used to be a bigger school building, and that they had actual separate classes. However, it seems something happened that made it become a single class. Now it stayed that way out of tradition. I was shocked at first, but humans adapt pretty quickly. I've already gotten quite used to it. The sound of children playing started right from the morning. With such a lively mood, it felt more like a kindergarten than a proper school. Not that that was a bad thing. Mion, who had been walking in front of us up to now, until now rather, suddenly let me take the lead. Right in front of the classroom door. So I was meant to slide the door open and enter the room first. Thanks, Mion. Thanks for helping with my social anxieties. Too bad. I wasn't going to fall for that again. Oh, is there a sneaky little shit on the other side of that door trying to do something?
ここで先頭を譲るとはな。お手並み拝見ってことかよ。
What is this music? Mion chuckled with a haughty smirk on her face.
どうしたの？二人とも。
下がってろ、レナ。危ないぞ。やつだ。
Oh no, who's she?
じゃあ、さとこちゃんが?
I don't know anything about no Satoko. Her name was Satoko Hojo. She was a disrespectful, impudent, bossy little fucking shit. The way she talks was annoying. But it would be immature to get worked up over just that. She does have one of those kid voices, though. The real problem was this.
Mie mie no wana da na. Hikido no ue ni hasanda kokuban keshi. Mie mie da ze, Satoko!
A haughty laugh came from beyond the door. Oh my god, are we gonna hear it? Is it gonna be the same laugh?
Omigoto,
Kei-chan. No, okay.
Koryaa, konkai wa shoubu atta ka na?
Iya. 相手はサトコだ。これだけとは思えない。
After falling for such intricate traps since the day I transferred, I no longer let my guard down. Satoko liked to combine a variety of traps. Traps that were simply there to bait you into the main one. Traps that relentlessly kept coming at you like a sadistic Rube Goldberg machine. The list goes on. As well as being clever, they almost never misfire. When you least expect it, she strikes. No escape. No time to relax. This is like building...
見たところ、黒板消しは普通。石とかは入れてないみたいだな。
I took a pretty heavy hit from a blackboard eraser loaded with rocks on my first day. Geez, trying to fucking kill the new transfer student.
じゃあさ、じゃあさ、ガラガラって開けて落としちゃえばいいんじゃないかな。
それだ!
That's what Satoko was after. Making me focus my attention upward, so as if I lifted my hand to the door, there were thumbtacks stuck to the sliding door handle with tape. A frightening trap. What an evil little shit. Who would do that? Potent and terrifying trap. That shit would hurt. Concealed by using the blackboard eraser.
But that was a good one.
Assured of my victory, I threw the door open and stepped into the room. I felt something strange at my ankle. It was similar to the sensation of a jump rope catching my leg. By the time I realized... What was that noise? boink. By the time I realized she had me, hook, line, and sinker, it was already too late. I began to fall into an almost picturesque manner. Oh, it's a little late for that, Mion. Instinctively reacting to Mion's shrill warning, I twisted my body in midair before landing on the floor. An inkstone, filled to the brim, was placed right where I would have landed. I shuddered, imagining the situation had I landed square on it. Oh my god, I'm just waiting to hear Satoko's laugh. If this is the anime accurate voice acting, it's gonna be interesting. Also, I gotta take a look at this classroom, because there's detail in here. I'm envious of this, especially considering that the teacher's desk is at the back of the classroom, which is not how we had it here in the West. At least I'm assuming that's the teacher's desk back there. Maybe it's not. It looks like how I remember from the anime. Except these look... Those chairs look really comfy. Some of them have, like, cushions on them. The fuck? We had to sit on metal. It's not fair. This fucking music, though. Please don't laugh. Okay, she didn't laugh. She's got her fang and everything. Still sprawled in an awkward position, I was greeted by a mocking voice. It seemed I'd inadvertently sprained my back a little when I landed. Yeah, you went and paralyzed yourself. Better than landing on the inkstone, though. Oh my god, okay. I'm gonna end up exploding if I don't calm myself, because fucking Rika is, like, the most precious character in this series. Dude, I'm not ready to hear her voice. A small hand gently rubbed my head.
This
is so cute. This small dainty hand continued to gently stroke my head. I thought about asking how rubbing my head would help my back, but I didn't. It's not so much about what you actually do, it's the thought that counts. Rika-chan greeted each of us with an adorable little bow. Isn't she just so precious? It was infectious. Rena, Mion, and I all bowed back. I do have to say that I can definitely see the difference between these console sprites and the Steam version sprites. Like, the Steam version is, it's a different style, but it's also, like, higher resolution, almost. This looks a lot more, I guess, anime, I guess, is what it is. But it's not... It's not bad. Yeah, no shit. I glared over in her direction. Satoko was whistling while rather deliberately trying to avoid eye contact. My ass. I picked up Satoko by the back of her collar. She's so small. She looks like a misbehaved cat when I do this. But a cat wouldn't be setting traps. She's much harder to deal with. I cocked my index finger on my thumb, letting it tremble as I brought it closer to Satoko's forehead.
I'm
寄らないでけだもの。
人様が聞いたら誤解するような言い方をするんじゃねえ。
A small hand tugged the back of my shirt. Oh no, it's Rika!
Keiichi が2日間もお休みしたから寂しかったのです。
Rika-chan really is just so... How could I do anything more after being told that? I know, right? Like... Oh my god, I know that this is like... It might be a bit dark, but I hope nothing happens to Rika, because... That would be really shit. Who at this point was on the verge of tears? Oh, right. I gently released my grip on Sotoko, who at this point was on a verge of tears. She still had her eyes clamped shut as she braced herself for the forehead flick.
Aww. Naicha dame desu, Sotoko. Naito, oo desu.
Rika gently petted the head of her prankster friend. You would never guess those two are the same age. Like 3 years old. I think Sotoko could learn a thing, or a million, from Rika-chan. Wait a minute. Okay, I don't... Dude, are we gonna get some knee paws? Oh my god, that'd be fucking epic. I don't know if they're in the visual novel, though. As she observed the scene, Rena's expression grew ecstatic as she began to swoon. Oh, no.
Satoko-chan, naiteru! Kaiii yo!
Mochikaecha dame da kara ne.
Iya! Datte, konna ni kaiii yo!
Donna ni kaiikute mo dame nano.
Demo... ちょっとくらいなら…ダメかな、ダメかな…
Renan kept a cutesy face even as outrageous ideas spewed from her mouth. According to Mion, Renan is ridiculously weak to cute things and always tries to take them home. Object or person.
ものもまずいが誘拐はもっとまずいぞ。諦めろ。
じゃあ見てるだけ、見てるだけだよ。それならいいよね。
Rena swooned over Satoko's crying form. Ew, gross. If a girl ever goes missing in Hinamizawa, I'll be forced to turn Rena into the authorities. Forgive me, Rena. I'll be sure to bring you care packages when they put you away. That's depressing, man. Oh god, everyone.
Satoko, Suzuri, anta no desho?
Just from Mion's single statement, the entire mood of the room shifted back to normal. The inkstone was bad, but the thumbtacks stuck to the door handle were an even bigger problem. I pulled the tape off carefully, making sure not to skewer myself. Even though Sotoko was the one who set it up, everyone had to pick up after her. By the time the teacher entered the room, the bedlam form before the... What? Had been neatly tidied up.
Manietta ne! Kids! Kyosuke!
Mion gave out the morning commands. I accidentally skipped a line there, I think. It went awkwardly quiet. Oh, no, music's back. It's difficult being the teacher for all these different grades in one classroom. She has to teach something different to each one. But naturally, she ends up spending all her time with the younger kids. Rena and Mion, being in the highest grade in the class, end up mostly doing self-study. They even end up helping teach the younger kids, so it seems like they can never get to their own studies. They're actually way behind where my studies have progressed to. As a result, I'm pretty much taking over for the teacher and helping Rena and Mion with their studies.
Keiichi-kun wa obenkyou oshieru no umai ne.
Aw, thank you, Rena.
Wakariyasui yo.
Rena took a breather after finishing highlighting an important section.
Oshieru hashi kara jishin ga naku naru yo. Jibun no rikai no asasa ga wakaru na.
She's not wrong, I guess. In contrast, this person over here is quite late. What the fuck is that? Something fair about things. For one, isn't she supposed to be in a higher grade than me?
Mion-sa, 一言じゃないぞ。 真剣にやんないとまずいぜ。 こんなレベルじゃ。
別に進学校を目指すわけでもないし。
Yeah, who would want to go into a prestigious school? Like, imagine if there was a school that you could go to for women that's really hard to get into and really prestigious, and like you have to do a whole bunch of shit to get into it. Imagine needing to do that. That'd suck.
受験に必要なそこそこができてりゃ十分十分。
Her staunch defiance was really something else. This was a different type of relaxed than somebody who already knew what was going to be on the entrance exams.
みーちゃん、ケイチくんが頑張って教えてくれるんだからさ、私たちも頑張ろうよ。レナは素直ないい子だな。先生がきっといい学校に進学させてやるからな。ありがとう。レナには特に教えてやるからな。二人きりでプライベートレッスンだぞ。
They have to say private lesson in Japanese. A puff of smoke shaped like a halo popped out of Rena's head. Does that happen in real life? I've never seen that before. Exactly what kind of private lesson is she fantasizing about that's making her turn so red? I'd like to hear the play-by-play for that next time. Excuse me? While Mion was flipping through her vocabulary flashcards, she threw out a casual question.
そうかいじゃさ、こんなに勉強しなきゃいけないわけ?
この程度はできないと進学できないね。進学できないから勉強するわけ?まあ、平たく言えばそうなるな。将来役に立たないのは承知で。That
is totally true.
こっちじゃさ、出席日数が足りてりゃみんな進学できるんだよ。Really?
Is there a school nearby that's literally in the middle of fucking nowhere? In the mountains? Surrounded by a forest?
So-so-なのか?
Study equals entrance exams. Having the basic law of the universe is so easily overturned sent me into a state of shock.
そうかもね。試験で振り落とさなきゃならないほど人もいないし。Weeding
them out. We weed them out.
誰でも進学できるならさ、そんなにガリガリとやることもないんじゃない?
まあ、そうだけど。 でも一般常識程度にはできた方が。おじさんはそんな無駄な勉強に時間をかけるよりさ、この思春期の貴重な時間をもっと有意義に過ごすために使うべきじゃないかなと考えるわけよ。Hey,
if the education system in Japan is anything like what I've heard, I totally agree with Mion here. It was too profound of a statement to simply laugh off. But since it was Mion, it probably didn't actually have that deep of a meaning. Wow, that's harsh. I hear ringing bells. In a place of chime, the sound of the principal waving a handbell drifted throughout the classroom. Does anyone remember in the original anime, the frickin' principal? Was it in this anime, or was it a different anime, where the principal stands in the hallway, like, multiple times throughout the anime, and rings the bell, but you never see his face? He always has his back turned, so you never know what he looks like. And it was always creepy to me. And the person I watched it with. I don't know if that was Higurashi or not, or if that was something else.
Yeah, oshimai, oshimai. Sa, tanoshii lunch time!
Sorry, Mion, I was taking a drink quick. Holy shit. In a complete 180 from her unmotivated state, Mion gave the commands that signaled the end of the morning period.
Keiichi-kun, ohiru ni shiyou.
Rena can speak in stars, apparently. Hold on, I'm actually going to turn the audio down just a little bit more here. I might have been making a very troubled face. Rena smiled brightly at me. Dude, I could eat. I'm actually kind of hungry right now. I've got a chocolate bar. It's not food, though. There seemed to be different cliques, even within the class. Most of them were divided up by gender and age, but our group was different. Our ages were different, and we had both boys and girls. You mean, you had boy and girls. But we weren't reserved around each other. This level of openness makes a transfer student like me pretty happy. Rena and Mion pushed their desks together so they were facing each other. At the same time, Satoko and Rika were slowly lugging their desks over as well. Rena waved her chopsticks in an unrefined manner, trying to hurry me along. Unless everyone was together, they wouldn't even open their lunch boxes. Hey. If it's good, it's good. Even though Satoko was hurling insults at me, she wouldn't open the lid to her lunchbox until I was there. Aw, how kind. Isn't Satoko such a nice little girl? I pulled out my lunchbox swiftly and dragged my chair over to join the circle. Okay. At first, this was kind of embarrassing, but I got used to it pretty fast. At this point, I probably wouldn't even open my own lunchbox if someone else was too slow. Our ages and genders may have all been different, but we were all friends. Oh, that is so sweet. I don't know, that really just hit me hard for some reason.
Itadakimasu!
Jesus fucking Christ, my ears. The sound of our little five-part chorus echoed beautifully throughout his fucking headset and almost burst his eardrums. Oh my god, what is that look Mion is giving me? Jesus. Really though, I've gotten pretty used to this group made up of all girls. Of course there are other boys in the class, but they were a lot younger, so they were scared to approach me. Well, that's to be expected. Younger boys just see older boys as scary. Do we? I don't remember if I did. Compare that to girls. Well, at least these girls aren't picky. We put all the side dishes in the middle where everybody was free to pick at them. I thought girls would mind sharing a meal with a guy, so I was a bit flustered joining in. However, Mio noticed that and teased me quite a bit. As a fruit of my efforts, I can now reach over and take sides from anybody's lunch. Buying into the fight that Satoko was starting, our chopsticks locked in a cross counter, stabbing into each other's lunches. After seeing my happy face, Rika-chan's expression broke into a little smile. By the way, Satoko and Rika-chan's lunches are always the same. It seems that Rika-chan makes it for both them every day. I was honestly impressed. The carrot rosettes were... Is that how you say that? Rosettes? Weren't from a mold. They were done by hand, with a knife. That's not easy to do. Well, yeah, because she's best character. Just when I thought they weren't going to do it. Okay, if we've got oh-ho-ho-hoing, then we better have some knee-pieing or I'm going to fucking kick someone's ass. Rena is a pretty good cook, actually. It seemed that the topic of conversation switched to Rena when she wasn't expecting it, making her blush and trip over her words. Rena's lunch really was the star of the table. Not only did it look good, it tasted good. Everyone else pulled from Rena's lunchbox constantly. Knocking Mion's chopsticks aside, I reached out, trying to secure my own portion. Satoko and Rika-chan reached over at the same time, and a struggle ensued. Everyone shoveled in mouthful after mouthful while praising it, and Rena's lunchbox was soon empty. Well, poor Rena, what's she gonna eat? It was kind of bad that no one thought to leave any for Rena. But Rena seemed rather satisfied as she looked on.
いかがかしら。レナさんもとてもお料理が上手ですことよ。ケイチさんとは大違いですの。
だからお前が威張ることじゃねえだろ。
サトコだってケイちゃんと変わらないじゃんよ。
Yeah, she doesn't know the difference between cauliflower and broccoli.
あんたブロッコリーとカリフラワーの区別つくようになったわけ。
Nice. I had a feeling that was coming up because that's like another classic Higurashi thing. Satoko's face went pale. Apparently the music cut out too. This is a serious thing.
Oi, oi. Broccoli to cauliflower no chigai nara ore datte wakaru ze.
Wakarimasu mono. Wakaru mo.
It's really hard for her to lie.
Keiichi-kun.どっちでも茹でてマヨネーズかけると美味しいじゃない
You put mayo in anything, you've ruined it, Rena. I'm starting to second guess your cooking skills.
いじめちゃかわいそうだよ。みーちゃんも。
Rena hurriedly tried to follow up, but Mion laughed hotly as she drew closer to Satoko.
まあまあ、家庭科の授業ってことで。じゃあ、サトコ、これは
Mion lifted up her chopsticks. Between them was a piece of green stuff wrapped in bacon. Ooh, what? I've never had broccoli wrapped in bacon. That's an interesting idea, because I fucking hate broccoli. Maybe if you put bacon around it, my American self will like it more.
でもそれ、アスパラ…
Shh! Rika! Shut up! Mion made eye contact with me, and within 0.3 seconds, I had Rika-chan's mouth covered. Holding a piece of bacon-wrapped asparagus, okay...And giving her two choices, that's pretty terrible. That's actually pretty clever, Mion, though. I like that she picks on everyone. It's not just Keiichi, it's not just the main character. That shows that this group of friends is, you know, has chemistry between each of them, as opposed to just towards one character. The blue one?
でも緑はその…
Oh, it still hurts to hear her whine like that. Did you know that blue plants are actually super rare, like naturally blue ones?
本当にどっちか分かってる?降参した方が良くない?
I'd expect no less from the class representative, the oldest.The way she drives people into a corner just shows how much experience she has. This is just a hunch, but being brought into the Sonozaki household must be quite the ordeal.
わかりますもの!わかるもん!
じゃあ答えなよ。
わかるもん。わかるもん。
Don't cry, Satoko. It's gonna make me cry.She finally broke down and started crying. When she acts like this, she actually starts to seem her age. Because she is young. Rena entered a state of euphoria. Satoko bawled her eyes out. Rena was in a state of bliss as she rubbed her cheek against Satoko's head and smothered her. Really a very content face. One that wouldn't care if the world ended right then. It was that kind of smile.Oh, she said Mimi, but I heard her say Mion-san.
Kai, Kai! 大丈夫だよ。レナお姉ちゃんが悪い人たちはやっつけちゃうからね。
Uh-oh.
Ima, 一体何が?
Why is Keiichi getting punched?Both of Rena's fists shot up with supersonic speed, striking Mion and me squarely into our faces. Before we knew it, Mion and I sprawled spread eagle on the floor, staring up at the ceiling with matching welts on our faces.
Keiichi-chan は食らうの初めてだよね。今日のはまだ甘い方。
Thanks, Mion. Thanks for scaring me.
甘いって、これよりまだ上があるってのかよ。
With that, Mion and I both slumped our heads back to the floor in unison. From now on, I'll be careful when I'm within striking distance of Rena.
Hora, Satoko-chan, yatsukechatta yo. Kawaii. Omochikaeri shitai.
Oh no, she's doing the thing. Making sure Rena couldn't see it, Satoko stuck her tongue out at us. Oh, you little shit. Damn it all, using Rena like a puppet. Rika-chan massaged our bruises without saying a word. Oh, there's that bell again. No matter what the day had held, the last school bell always came too soon. Yeah, never mind, I'll let it go. Our shadows stretched off into the distance.
Hey, Keiichi-kun, tomorrow is... Nanika yote to kaaru kana? Kana?
No. It was such a direct question from Rena, I inadvertently blushed. If it was for a date, then wouldn't you be more subtle? Rena saw me lost for words and realized that I misunderstood and turned red as well. So apparently that isn't what she meant. Damn it. But since it's always fun when Rena's in a panic, I went along with it a little.
Nanda? Soyu no ja nai no ka yo?
Playing it up, I slumped my shoulders, feigning dejection.
Keiichi-kun, nande gakkari shiteru n daro? Taro? Mii-chan?
That was an interesting laugh, Mion. I'm sorry. Unable to hold it in any longer, Mion slapped me on the back. Mion was rolling on the floor, clutching her stomach while Rena flailed around, completely bewildered. I couldn't help but start laughing as well, feeling just a bit guilty. I ruffled Rena's hair. She really is a cute one. You were watching me, you little shit. It was only a momentary lapse, but there was no way Mion would let such a delectable detail slip by her. Saying anything more was also a bad idea. In my bewildered state, I slipped further into an unfavorable position. After that, Mion continued to tease me about it for a while.
で、明日が暇だと何なんだよ、レナ。
何の話だっけ?
It had been so long that Rena had forgotten. That's how long Mion had teased me.
ケイちゃんさ、まだこの雛見沢一人じゃ回れないでしょ?
That was true. I hate to say it, but if you blindfolded me and spun me around three times like we're playing pin the tail on the dickhead, I wouldn't be able to tell up from down from here.
そうだな。街へ行くのと学校へ行く以外はまだ自信ないな。
そうそう。それでね、明日ね、みーちゃんとレナでお散歩しながら、ケイチ君にひなみざわを案内してあげようよってことになって。
That would be a godsend. Frankly, I was happy about the offer. I would be too.
もちろん行くでしょ?
I'd be happy to just talk to someone.
暇ならな。
女の子が誘ってんじゃん。
Yes, I'm aware.
暇ならな。
If I'm free. Nice.
どうせ暇なんでしょ?
暇ならな。
I was being stubborn as to not give a clear yes or no. Even though I thought it was a godsend, I'm much too much of a scamp to say so up front.
Keiichi-kun, 暇じゃないのかな? かな?
While Mion and I had a rather sour back and forth, Rena peeked over at me hesitantly. Figuring I'd be a bit too rough on her, I just gave in.
すまん。許せ、ごめん。暇だ。
Aw, that's sweet.
よかった。
The trepidation disappeared from Rena's face as it blossomed into a smile.
Oh, oh! Mion-san to Rena-san じゃ随分と温度差がありますじゃん?
There is a bit of a difference. It seems Mion didn't care for how rude I was to her compared to how quickly I agreed with Rena. Aw, she's jelly. But her being annoyed was very interesting. So I pushed Rena forward, speeding up our pace to leave Mion behind.
行こう、Rena. 明日は二人きりで出かけような。嫌味なミオンは置いてって。
Aw, how rude.
え?あ、ケイチ君がそれでいいなら。
案内しようって提案したのは私。仕方すんな、前原ケイチ。
二人きりでピクニック嬉しいな。弁当は持ってくか、アレナ。
お弁当いるなら、レナ作っちゃおうかな。かな。